I do have one question for you, if I may. Where do we stand on this pollution control when they try to say that our the cooling pipes that go across Hampton to the ocean that keep the Seacoast nuclear power plant running to keep it cool are pollution devices, mm-hmm. rather than absolute necessity keep it from melting down?
That is a bill we have been fighting for a long time, either trying to repeal that or put some time limits on it, and we don't get very far.
I appreciate your efforts on that, because one could argue successfully, in my opinion, that without those pipes, it would literally melt right through the ground, like it happened, at Three Mile Island or one of those, or in Japan recently.
Judy, is the problem with that we have so few communities that are impacted by that?
There are all kinds of communities, because there's all kinds of things that are out there on different types of power plants and all that are considered pollution control devices. They are things that are required to be in place in order to meet federal requirements for emissions and all that. It's not like a tax incentive is what makes the company put that in. They have to comply with federal law. So we underwrite, as municipalities, we underwrite the company expenses. They have good lobbyists.
Well, the thing is, if you have a coal, producing electricity, a power plant like that, then you want that pollution allowance and credit, and give them all the power they can to help put that in place. I have no argument with that. But when you take a look at Hampton and the Seabrook power plant, without those tubes, it's bye-bye power plant, literally.
We get into this debate.
Madam Chair, if I might, just one
question. Quickly, okay. And I would say, if anybody has, keep it to
I would note, by them running those steam pipes through town, they're causing local warming, thermal pollution here in Hampton.